Hello and welcome to another presentation and demo on design for manufacturing in ADS. But this one is going to be on sensitivity analysis. This slide represents the DFM design process for MMIC. And you can see once you start your design, start your nominal design here, usually designers, the next step, they optimize their design. And what I'm showing here, once you have the setup, the circuit setup to be optimized, you can automatically access the sensitivity analysis tool. It takes few seconds to get a fast response or a fast analysis on the sensitivity of the components in your design. So let's see how sensitivity analysis works in ADS. Basically in ADS sensitivity analysis, what it does, it takes one component at a time in your design. For example here, if we have a capacitor C1, what sensitivity analysis does is it increases the capacitor C1 to C1 prime. And C1 prime is 1 times e to the minus 6 larger than C1. So it increases the component by a very, very small factor, which is 1 times e to the minus 6, 1 times 10 to the minus 6 of the nominal value. And by doing this, it will look for the response. What is the gain? What is the return loss? What is the noise figure? Whatever you're looking for. So it looks for the response at the nominal value, and it also looks at the response of the circuit at the new value, which is 1 times 10 to the minus 6 of the nominal value. And you can see the difference in the response, we represent it with delta R, and the difference in the component value, which is delta C here. So basically the sensitivity is calculated to be delta R divided by delta C. And this is the amount of change you get in the response relative to that little amount, 1 times 10 to the minus 6 factor of the component value. Okay, so I just want to mention here that sensitivity analysis is local. It's localized. That means it is taken at one component at a time, regardless of the interaction of the other components. We just take resistor R, do the sensitivity analysis only on that resistor, then we do capacitor, then we do the other components, but not altogether varying. So it's localized, okay? It kind of gives you a quick analysis on the sensitivity of that part. I want to mention in the previous video, we have other video and presentation on yield sensitivity histograms. All the parts vary at the same time, and it gives you a much more meaningful results on the sensitivity of that component relative to everything moving at the same time. But sensitivity analysis, again, is localized. It's done on one component at a time. But it's really quick. It's in few seconds you can access that. You can simulate it. In like few seconds you get an idea of how sensitive these components are. But I do recommend to use the yield sensitivity histograms and the design of experiments to make a full understanding of the behavior of your design for manufacturing. So here's an example of a run in ADS. Notice here I have the input matching network, capacitor C1, I have the interstage matching network, capacitor C8 and C4, and I have the output matching network, capacitor C6 and C7. And I'm looking here at the S22 spec. Notice that C1 input matching network and C8 interstage matching network has no effect, no sensitivity to the output return loss. But as we move closer to the output matching network, we find out C4, which is close to the output matching network, it's in the interstage matching network, has a little effect, sensitivity to the S22, but the biggest sensitivity is coming from the capacitor in the output matching network, which makes sense. So C6 is the red X component here, or the sensitive part, and C7, which might be a big, huge bypass capacitor, had no effect because it's a big capacitor just for bypassing purposes. So this is how, you know, you can tell. You list the components on the x-axis and you list the measure you're looking at on the y-axis, and just visually you can see clearly what components is more sensitive than another. One thing I want to mention in ADS, when you do sensitivity analysis, you can access two types of analysis, two types of results. We have the absolute sensitivity and we have the normalized sensitivity. But they both give you a different meaning to the sensitivity. And I do have a document written specifically to explain the difference between absolute sensitivity and normalized sensitivity. Please feel free to access that by asking for it from the representative, Agilent representative. But let me illustrate to you in the next slide. Normalized sensitivity calculation is more meaningful to designers. I'm a designer and I always, 99% of the time, I always access the normalized sensitivity analysis. I recommend that you use it because basically what it does, you know, the results have more meaning to you. It gives you the percent change in the response versus a 1% change in the component value. It's all normalized. You have many components. For every 1% change in that component value, you can see the percent change in the response, in the gain, in the noise figure, in the power output. So this is normalized. It's very easy to compare which component is sensitive more than another component. In the absolute sensitivity calculations, what ADS calculates or gives you, it gives the change in the response, like the change in the gain, for example, versus 1 unit change in the component value. If you have a 10 ohm resistor, for 1 unit change, for 11 ohm, from 10 to 11 ohms, what is the gain change? But be careful when you compare apples with apples here, when you compare the units. This is why I recommend the normalized sensitivity calculation. It's all normalized to percent change in the component value. So you can really compare, you can compare the analysis, sensitivity analysis, relative to all components equally, because they're all changed by the same factor, percent. Okay? So let me now show you a demo using ADS. Okay, so let's go to ADS. And the same LNA, the KU band LNA design I used in the other demos, the design of experiments and the yield sensitivity histogram demo. And by the way, this project is available in ADS examples directory under microwave circuits. It is the KU band LNA DFM circuit. So you can access it and simulate it yourself. But again, you know, this is the input matching network, and this is the interstage or the FET structure. Here's the resistor lines and the FET, and here's the output matching network, output port, the DC port, which takes the voltage supply, DC port. So, as I said before, designers usually go through the nominal design followed by optimization. So notice here,